Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Ravenloft, Strahd's Possession. Where we last left off, we were trolling about in a temple, and we were looking for the final piece of the parchment that we are missing. We have, as far as I am aware, explored this level. And I want to say probably in its entirety, unless I missed a secret somewhere, which I suppose is a possibility. But I'm not going to hold to it. So what we're going to do now is actually check the upper levels again, and make sure that we aren't missing anything up there, because I have been known to miss the glaringly obvious. Come on, squeeze through that door, guys. There we go. Okay. See, like, that we're seeing zombies, that leads me to believe that we have missed the glaringly obvious, and there's, like, a secret down here. And that it's over here leads me to believe that it's in this area. So we're gonna kind of poke around a little bit. The howls of the undead give their positions away. Okay, make sure- oh, damn it. Wrong button. Auto map. Okay, so we're gonna kind of poke around in this room. Yeah, I hear the undead. I hear the zombies. Yes, guys, I know. You are about and likely agitated. Okay. Okay, so there's nothing in here. Then it might be this room over here. I mean, it could be this room, I suppose, but if I recall correctly, we already found a piece of parchment over there. So I'm going to kind of lean away from it being in that half of the dungeon, because I think that's where we found, like, all of the pieces of the parchment thus far. So let's kind of poke around in here. Some moths around a flame. And nothing of interest. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything. Unless there's, like, a... there could be, like, a passage we missed upstairs that leads down another set of stairs into this area, I suppose. but the only other place that there could be a secret is, like, down here. Unless there's one along the walls, like, right here. In which case, I suppose I could just kind of, like, do that. Excuse me. Sorry, my throat's kind of froggy today, folks. I do not know what the dealio is. Yeah, there's nothing along here. I don't know. I suppose we can go check. I mean, one more time, just run around real quick. It's a straight shot, relatively speaking, so... freaking door. Just here to troll. Okay. And let's see, I think that's through here. Oh no, Swell's bless wears off. Whatever will he do? See, I think that is this room, correct? Yes. Alright. Yeah, we've got a crappy scroll. Friggin' magical stones I don't care about. Yeah, there's nothing. Nothing at all. And in here is, likewise, not a dang thing. And no false walls. Yeah, I don't know. Okay, I do, have the walkthrough for this. The CD version comes with it on the CD. Same thing with, like, the talkie versions of Ravenloft and Menzoberranzan. They both came with, like, little walkthrough PDF files on the CDs. But I'm going to kind of avoid depending on it too heavily, because that's not fun. But we may need to here. I do not know. Gonna poke around in here, see my map, and see if we missed any items. There's something we missed up there, but I'm willing to bet that's probably just a potion, but I will go check it. Let me get the magic mirror of Spotify ads over there. Alright. Okay, so what is this? Is it fucking crappy mace? Yeah. Bleh. Alright, one thing I actually do think I'm gonna do is we're gonna sleep here, kind of recharge. And we'll recast our detect magic, and that'll be it for the time being. Yeah, this is frustrating. Under Toe of Evil Artifacts. Ah, there we go. So we gotta put them in the book. So I wonder what happens if we look at it. Alright. At dusk, the piece we're missing. At midnight, the mirrored sun. Damn it, I accidentally just used it again. Oh, no, no, I didn't. I thought I did. It's cool that they let us combine it, though. It kind of saves inventory space. Hi there, preachy, cryy guy. Alright. Well, it's obvious what we're looking for is down here, then, because we got zombies groaning loudly and a confused Let's Player, so. See, this is just all my keys, right? Yeah. Even though we found the super handy key ring last episode. So I actually don't suppose anybody has detect secret doors. I don't even know if that's in this. Pray. No. Dang it. I tried. Yes, Zombro, I know. I know. You want to be found and put out of your misery. I'm looking for you. I'm looking. See, this is, yeah, this is the little double. Yeah. This is the area that had that monster that I have no idea what it was, I just fireballed it. You guys don't understand, I was terrified there. I don't know what that thing was. And I had to make sure. And you know, when you want to make sure, you nuke it from orbit. Come on. Come on. Keep getting stuck on invisible terrain. Okay. See, I know that's just the armory over there, but I suppose we can do another quick once over. All the crap that we got left lying in here. I think this is just the bronze plate, I think. Yeah. White robe, shield. Man, I do not know. Oh, I do know I'm getting freaking stuck on the terrain, though. My gosh. There we go. Well, like, there's only so many places there can be secrets. Oh! Oh, what is that? That is intriguing. Let's go freaking investigate that. What do we have? I don't know. Might just be like a... I don't know. Nothing important. I'm gonna guess that's probably the case. See, and this is the button. See, that opens those doors. Yeah. I'm actually gonna go ahead and keep them open. There. Okay, well, we have a little room where it could be up here, I suppose, so we can quickly give this room a once-over. But I am highly doubting that there's going to be anything of any value, because there's already one secret in here. Well, I shouldn't say secret, but there was one button in here. And it's not really like the game devs to hide multiple buttons in the same area, because that's too easy. Okay, we got a robe. Make sure there's, you know, nothing too interesting in here. Okay. I don't know, folks. Just like, does this open anything? No. I don't know. Yeah, there is just not a damn thing. Man, I hate to do it, but I think I'm going to have to refer to Ye Olde's strategy guide, so I am going to pause the video here. I'm actually going to save, too, because we have yet to do that. And I will be back in just a moment. Until then, folks. Okay, according to the mini-map, well, the map that they give you, there's actually two ways to get into this secret, and one of them's in this room. It's right here. Yeah. One of these walls seems, well, unusual. Perhaps a closer examination is ordered. Would have been helpful if you'd have told me that from, like, you know, when we entered the room. Because, yeah. They're secret walls. Let's see. And then there's another one. Yeah, right over there. Oh, and they show us that one. Freaking jerks. Oi. I apologize for wasting 10 minutes of you guys' time. Oh, is this a trap? Did I see something on that wall, or was I imagining it? An odd imperfection of some sort? Rare. Oh, yeah. Ow. Thanks for that gold leaf, by the way. That was... Ow. Or not. Okay, so there's a trap on the one wall. Oh, and there's another button right here. Seriously? Seriously. Is there another one, like, along here, too? They want to get me three times? Because they're jerks. Yeah. Eh. Okay, that one worked. Oh god, we got zombies. Zombies everywhere! Holy crap. Burning hands. Now we stab them to death because they're all weak now. There. This is a private place. A personal chapel for the head priest of this church. Alright. I don't know why I was full of zombies then. Oh! Here we go. Last parchment fragment. Let's see what this shit says. Velik is almost dead again. At dusk, the cock crows. At midnight, the mirrored sun. Okay. It's obvious that the book is having no effect. If it must be used closer to the mirror, we may see things take on a different light. Perhaps even the liberation of that poor trapped soul. Well, yeah, yeah. I just wanted to see what it said. I wasn't necessarily using it. Anything behind there? No. Okay, what's on our mini-map? Alright, so yeah, we've cleared this. We're gonna get out of here. And... see... oh my god, am I trapped on a box? Yes. Oh. See, like, I'd have never thought to look there. It's a shame that, like, throwing these doesn't throw them through the fake wall. That would have been hilarious. And chances are, if I did it, I wouldn't have even noticed. Because I'm dumb. Okay. So we're gonna rest here. Yes. And we're gonna save. And I knew there was something. I knew it. You guys friggin' saw that. I knew. I was in the right area. I even knew that, like, the general area of it, I just didn't think to go running around into walls because I figured my elves were going to be helpful. Okay. We'll do this. Oh. Krazow. Okay. So now I assume we can go talk to Priesty McPriesterson in the main chapel area here. Priesty, yeah. Ooh, he's like inflating. It's good to see you mobile again, old priest. I take it the spirit in the mirror was yours.
Oh, it was me. Indeed it was. Whoever you are, thank you. But go now. I am weary, and this is no longer holy ground. It has been corrupted by the evil of Count Strahd von Zarovich. He came upon us as might a madman. No mortal could have defiled my church so easily, or dealt such vile blows to holy men. As if we were thieves, or worse.
We've seen the bones of another within your church. Was this the intruder who cursed you, or perhaps another of your flock?
He was my novitiate. A devoted young man slain by Strahd the night my spirit was cast into the mirror. If only the vigor of life could be returned to his loyal bones, I'm certain he would work to bring the Count to justice. I myself am too weary from the ordeal, and I believe no mere spell can raise his dead bones. A resurrection is necessary.
We had thought to venture into the cemetery behind your church, but we were unable to pass its mighty gate. Is there a key?
There is a key. Giving it to you is the only reward a poor priest can provide for the gift of his spirit.
Sweet. Alright. Well, now we can get into the cemetery. Throw that under a key ring, and I guess we're gonna head out. Not too interested in resurrecting his novitiate because we already have clerics. Well, we have a cleric and a paladin, so yeah, I think we're okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and guess that we are supposed to get into the graveyard, which I think was over here. Yes. Okay, look. Okay. I think that's one of those things that was in the crypt. I want to know what this thing is. I'm curious. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. Where is it? Come on, already. Just... Oh... Come on. What is it? Is that like a ghoul? Is that a... Yes, that is a ghoul, as Velika just found out. Nice. Okay. Yeah, we'll rest. Okay, I'm gonna save again. Okay. Into the graveyard. Ghouls are nasty. As you can see, they paralyze you. Holy crap. I'm being meleeed. Oh man, we got a nice pack of them out here too. Can I just like cook them all? No. I cooked one. Hey, she survived that one. God, burning hands is so nice. Look at that. Should... As I throw her armor at it. Alright, I suppose I should... Oh, no, I do not wish to cast that. Damn it. Just wasted a magic missile. I'm gonna buff my party up here. Draw strength. And... Bless. And a fireball for good measure. Bam! Wapow! Swell. Look busy. Okay. Well, we got some stuff over there, but there's also a swarm of enemies. I want to see what's over here. Because less swarm of enemies. Oh, and we're going inside. I got bats and a ghoul. Oh, no, that's a ghast. Ghasts are ghoul plus ones. Ghouls plus one, I suppose. Whereas ghouls paralyze you on hit, ghasts do as well, but if I recall correctly, ghasts also have like basically an aura of stank that hurts you. Hey, another key ring. Okay, I'm liking this. Multiple key rings. That makes me happy. Mage Scroll Claws of the Umber Hulk. Sure, we'll give that to Velika, actually. is this? Cure serious wounds. Sure, free heal pod. And this is crap. And this is crap. Trying to put random stuff in them. See, is this a key now? Alright. I'm gonna throw some of this stuff. Alright, so this is a key, the vestibule key. That makes sense. We're gonna throw some stuff in here. Keep Gold Leaf's extra stuff in there. Potion of Speed. His Rod of Smiting can stay. And Strahd's Invitation. I don't know if we still need this, but I'm gonna hold on to it. Likewise, I'm gonna hold on to the Tome of Evil Artifacts and Didgeridoo. Cure Serious, Flame Strike, Atonement. Let's see, I think. Scroll of Atonement is a quest item. Room of Curse. Instructions to the catalog. Right, I'm gonna hold on to those. Remove Curse, I wanna keep. Let's see, there's a Paladin Holy Symbol. These, I don't even know. Scroll of Ice Knife. I'm actually gonna get rid of this. And Tremia's catalog, I'm gonna hold on to. Alright, so we got a bunch of crap. And, yeah. I suppose I could sleep in here, but I'm already buffed up and lazy. Adventure, damn it. I'm still bothered by the fact that I had to freaking look up in the clue book that, like, there were secret doors in there. I'm like, I knew that there were freaking hidden doors, I just didn't, yeah. I'm irritated. I hate having to look crap up when I'm playing games. It drives me nuts. I mean, I'm sure it drives some of you guys nuts, too, because it's, like, fucking basically cheating. And that's boring. What the hell is that? Okay, that's not terrifying. Like, those are just ghouls. I'm not too worried about them. I am, however, worried about that. Was that, like, a freaking banshee or something? A wraith? What are you? You a vampire? Yes. Yes, it is. Fireball wand. Magic missile wand. Another fireball. Okay, so there are vampires out here. That does kind of equate to Gene running back with his tails between his legs to memorize spells and stuff. I am also going to switch out on Gloriana here. Switch out her Knock and Improved Identify for Ice Knives so that she's got some offensive magic, because, like, Identify and stuff, while helpful, are things that I'm generally going to have time to be able to be like, okay, I'm just going to sit here and rest and memorize Knock. Oh, damn it. Accidental Dispel Magic. Okay, we will bless. Okay. Out we go. Round 3. Detect magic. Okay. So we got vampires. I do not want to get into melee with vampires, because if they're like pen and paper vampires, they level drain you. And level drain makes Gene a sad panda. Oh hey. Oh hey. Get out of here. So there's another one out there. I see, like, the blue. And there's another one out there. Alright, so there's at least two more vampires milling about in here. Oh, hey. Oh, hey. And these ghouls blend in with the ground. But they're not... Oh, hey, another vampire. That's nice. Burning hands for everyone. Have a nice knife. Okay, I can't tell whether or not that actually hurt it, but the fireball did. The good thing about the vampires is I bet you they are worth a bit of experience. Like, I bet we're kind of eking a little closer towards leveling now, maybe. Yeah, 5,000, 2,000, I don't know, Velika's actually getting close to hitting a fighter level. Freaking Gold Leaf is nowhere near it, and Gloriana's also hurting. Gloriana's also, like, incredibly encumbered because of this chest oh crap. Okay. Well, I don't care that she's encumbered, actually, because... She's in the back row. I'm okay with that. Alright, we're gonna go in here. I'm gonna save first because we got, like, statues outside and stuff. I'm just waiting to, like, come in here to a vampire lord or something. See? I knew. I knew. Did she get level drained? No. That's good, at least. See, folks, this is why. This is why. Gene knows. I've freaking... No. Game devs ain't gonna pull this shit on me. I've played Baldur's Gate 2. Freaking... running around the freaking... the graveyard in Athkatla, and you're like, I'm just gonna go into this tomb, and the game's like, LOL, here's a lich. Which, for those of you that aren't too familiar with D&D, is a bad thing. Get out of here. What is that? Just some dirt? Yeah. Okay. I mean, I don't want to melee these things, but I kind of have to. I'm just chewing through charges on my wand of fireball. Like delicious candy. But, you know, use it or lose it, I guess. Make sure I don't have any more sneaking up on me. Alright, let's see what we got in here. Got another one? No. Well, that's pleasing. Just a little empty room. Safe to sleep. Draw strength. Prayer. Let's see here. Then bless on her. And detect magic. Man, what is her name? Velika. Oh my god, I've known her name this entire episode, and all of a sudden my brain's like, hey, Gene, guess what you forgot? And I'm like, what? And it's like her name. And I'm like, oh. Terrible. It's terrible. My memory is just going. I'm surprised I remember how to move sometimes. Get out of here. Freaking ghouls. These guys, not too bad. Outside of that lucky paralysis that first one got on Velika, the front row seems to be making their saves pretty aptly here. I'm sure the back row would probably get decimated, though. Oh, crap. My god. Hey, Swell just leveled. Velika retained her levels. Excuse me. Yeah, look at that. The thing was worth like 1,500 experience points. So more than that, because I think she was like 1,800 to leveling. But we have killed some ghouls. So yeah, Swell hit a level. He gained some extra hit points. Maybe spells. I don't know. No. No. And in here, we have a cloak that is non-magical, a scroll of lightning bolt, sure, and a ring of wizardry. That is glowing to Gloriana, and that will give her some extra spells per day. Maybe. Yeah, third level spells. Wow, three extra third level spells a day. That I'm okay with. I think we're going to go with fireballs and lightning bolts because I don't know if lightning bolts in this will pierce enemies. In normal 1st and 2nd edition, lightning bolts were a line and they were awesome because they bounced and killed half your party when you aimed them wrong and your DM was being a dick. Swell just lost a level. Thank you, vampire. How close is he? Yeah, he's got to earn all of that experience all over again. I'm not particularly distraught by this though. Though the temptation to load is... Yeah, damn it. Oh wow, we were a ways back, huh? Yeah. I thought I'd saved again. Oh well. Oh, damn it. Yes. Did she lose a level? No. But yes, that is why I'm dead or dicks. Less so in newer editions because of how they handle negative levels, but back in the days of yore, it was not fun. Alright, we're just gonna rush this place. There. Oh my god, and Velika died. Like, I'm not particularly bothered because we do have the raised dead bag, but still. Velika, why are you so terrible? This ring of wizardry is coming at a great price. Alright, give her that, but it's totally worth it. Okay. Gloriana, the fireballs, and a lightning bolt. There are actually... I think that actually doesn't function properly to a ring of wizardry. I don't recall, like, 100% sure on this, but I thought rings of wizardry, like, doubled the number of spells you got of certain levels, not increased them by a flat number. I mean, I'm not gonna complain because we're getting four times the number of spells we'd normally be getting at third level. but I don't know. I don't know. I got a complaint. But yeah. I just, like, remember Rings of Wizardry being, like, stupidly powerful in, like, Baldur's Gate and stuff, because they, like, double your first level spells or double your third level spells or whatever. But hey, I will take a bunch of extra spells here. Right here. Let's see what Lightning Bolt does. Badoosh! Alright, so no, it does not. In fact, and I've got a vampire chewing on my butt, I think. Yeah, because ghouls don't hit for 14 damage. But your fireballs do, though. Alright, so Swell should be getting right there. Yeah, 700 experience points away. I want to know. Come on, there we are. Alright, I don't know how much XP those are worth. So those are worth about 400 or 40 XP apiece, 44 XP apiece. And Velik is gonna die again if I'm not careful. Hey, well. Get out of here. Where's my burning hands? There. I'm gonna give you guys burning hands too if you don't friggin' screw off. Jerks. And we're gonna go a little bit over time today because I wasted so much time in the noob dungeon there. Or the temple. Undercroft. Where is this ghoul? Am I standing on it? Yes. Oh, yeah. Nice collision detection there, game. Got some burning hands. Oh, what do we got here? Pouch of unusual golden dust. Okay, we'll hold on to that, but I'm not going to use it. See, now would be the time to have Gloriana memorize unimproved identify. And sleep. Can I sleep? Yes. Ha! Oh, crap. Damn it, Swell. Swell loses a level, and stupidly, Jean did not save again. Did I save? I don't remember. Was I that stupid? Did I seriously not save again? No. This time Jean saved again, like a good little boy. Alright, we've even got all our crap memorized. Bless. I'm actually gonna... Before I get all my buffing done here... Let's see, where's negative plane protection? It's third level. Here, we're gonna pull those off and get negative plane protection. There. Swell, because you're terrible. You get negative plane protection. Velika, less terrible than Swell, also gets it. Prayer. Alright, draw strength. And detect magic, and bless on Velika. There. Full buff routine done, saving. Okay. Ignoring you. Come over here and grab this thing. I'm sure I've missed some other stuff while running around out here. Oh, nothing over here. Okay, maybe I didn't miss any stuff. Okay, cool. Get out of here. Oh, hey. Have a lightning bolt, dick. And a fireball. Alright, so the lightning bolts don't really appear to do much to the vampires. The fireballs, however, appear to be quite effective. Freaking ghouls. Alright, I don't think we've been in here. Keep the spellbook at the ready. And apparently there's nothing in here. Okay. Whatever. Oh man, we got like an army of the undead. They just need to flood this graveyard with holy water. I love how, like, the ghouls are just gone, and the vampire's like, yup, still around. I'm still stuck stabbing things with ineffectual weapons. Alright. Oh, hey! She's like, I'm coming around for ya. And I'm like, fireball! And Swell leveled. Yay. Man, Velika is right there. She's probably gonna gain, like, 2 hit points. I thought that there was one on my butt chewing on me. Give him the ice knives. Ready them burning hand spells. Oh, Swell is paralyzed. Thankfully not petrified. Velika can melee things. Oh, there's... Is that like an NPC over there? Oh, that's intriguing. Okay. Seriously. Okay, now that we're out of magic, Swell's petrified, and I'm generally confused. Alright, what do we got in here? Another... Oh, just some skeletons. Okay. I'd be like, maybe I should do something a little smarter than just randomly charging in, but the game's like, no, you're okay. Ooh, an axe of hurling. Those are nice, they return to you. Some Kyog Toms. And non-magical chainmail. Alright, an axe of hurling. Well, we're gonna rest here. Yes, and find out who can use this thing, if anyone. Okay, she can. She cannot. Damn. That's a shame. I was hoping that Gloriana could, actually. But, okay. 2 to 4, 2 to 4. 1 to 6, 1 to 6. Alright, so my... Well, the average damage on them is... roughly on par. This one is... yeah, 3 versus 3.5. This has the range to it, though, but I'm not going to actually use it. If I had 2 of them, I would. I'd have her dual wield them, but I don't, so I won't. We are sitting at, like, 35 minutes, though, so I actually think that this is where I'm going to call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time. Until then.